ओम अखंडम सच्चिदानंदम अवांग मनस गोचरम आत्मानम अखिलाधारम आश्रये भीष्ट सिद्धये। हियर वी आर स्टडिंग सदानंद यतीस वेदांत सार एंड वी आर टोल्ड दैट द गुरु टीचेस द शिष्य बाय द मेथड ऑफ अध्यारोप एंड अपव and we understood this in two different ways. First way tells us that we have to superimpose the whole world on Brahman and then remove that superimposition by telling that Brahman is not this, not this. That leads from immanent God to transcendent God. But we understood also the second method in which, as Sri Ramakrishna said, neti neti aniti iti, we understand that the world is nothing but a superimposition on Brahman, thereby establishing that Brahman is beyond this world. And then we to see that that very Brahman appears as this world. So that is called abhavat. Now, in that context, whole adhyarop has been explained up till now in two parts, the general about the whole world and especially about our own self. So the topic of adhyarop is over. Now he must take up the topic of apava. So we start from sentence 137. Apavado nama रज्जु विवर्तस्य सर्पस्य रज्जुमात्रत्ववत् वस्तु विवर्तस्य अवस्तुनो अज्ञानादे प्रपंचस्य वस्तुमात्रत्वम्। ए न्यू वर्ड हैज कम हियर दैट इज विवर्त एंड दैट विल बी डिफाइंड इन द नेक्स्ट श्लोक बट वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इट हियर बिकॉज द वर्ड हैज अकर्ड हियर. And he says, apavado nama, that means, what is apavad? I am explaining now. Rajju vivartasya sarpasya. Sarpa is being seen in place of Rajju without any change in Rajju. That is the meaning of vivarta. Sarpa is being seen in Rajju without any change in Rajju. Snake is being seen in place of rope, without the rope having gone into any change. That is called vivarta. So the translation would be snake which is being seen in place of rope without any change in rope, rajju matratvavat. We see that it is only rajju. We see that the snake was superimposed. It is only rajju. And that Rajju itself was appearing as the snake. Snake was an appearance. Rajju is the reality. To see Euro in place of snake which we were seeing. We are seeing snake because we had superimposed. Because snake was superimposed on Rajju. Not that we had superimposed, but the snake was superimposed on Rajju. So we are seeing only the snake. But if we can, we understood that it is Rajju. But if we can see that very Rajju now in place of snake, that is the apavad. Rajju matratvavat, this is an example. As we see rope, which has been rope always, but we are seeing it as snake, to see in place of that, to see the rope like that. Vastu vivartasya avastu no. The reality, without any change in the reality, was appearing as something unreal. Something unreal was appearing in place of the reality without the reality having changed. What was the unreal thing? Agyanade prapanchasya. Starting from our wrong knowledge, up to the whole manifold world, including ourselves. So the whole manifested world including the so-called I consciousness, was being seen in place of the reality which is Brahman. But now, vastu matratvam, to see the reality in place of this manifold world, to see the reality in place of our wrong knowledge and the manifold world, to see the reality in place of seeing them, in place of seeing, being aware of our wrong knowledge and up to the manifold world, if we can see that it is the reality, then that is apavat. So that is what iti iti, reality we are seeing now. And then that vivarta is explained and differentiated from a similar word. And that similar word is vikara. Vikara is a modification. We cannot say that milk appears as curd. Milk has changed and curd has come. Milk is changed into curd. So that is called modification. That is called vikara. But rope has not changed. Snake is appearing. That is called vivarta. So taduktam satatvato anyatha pratha vikara iti idhirita vikara iti udhirata atatvato anyatha pratha vivarta iti udhirita satatvato anyatha pratha. Pratha means appearance. Anyatha, different. Satatvato, that means including the original nature. If it changes and something else appears, that is called vikara. I just know you in the example, milk has changed and become curd. Then we call it modification or vikara. Atatvato anyatha pratha, the nature has not changed, appears as different, that is called vivarta. Nature of not change, nature of rope has not changed, appears as snake, that is called vivarta. Milk has changed into curd, so it called vikara. In this way, some people think that God has become this world. That means God has changed. So that is called vikara. But the reality has not changed. Reality appears as this world. That is called vivarta. Yes. And this vivarta was used in the previous sentence that without change in reality, the world was an appearance. But instead of that appearance, if we can see the reality itself, that is called apavat. Tathahi. So, giving the example of vivarta and vikar, now he says in that way. Etat bhoga yatanam chaturvida sakala sthula sharira jatam bhogya rupa annapana adikam etat ayatana bhuta bhuradi chaturdasha bhuvanani etat ayatana bhutam brahmandam cha etat sarvam etesham karana rupam panchikruta bhuta matram bhavati. So where the adhyarup ended, from there the apavat starts. We were told that this grossified, panchikrutam is combined, grossified five elements. That has become the whole world. Combined, grossified five gross elements has become this entire world. Now if instead of entire world, we see it is only five gross elements. That is the one step in apavat. Etat bhoga yatanam, the seat of enjoyment. What is the seat of enjoyment? Chaturvida sakala sthula sharira jatam. All bodies born of four types. Born of embryo, born of egg, born out of earth, and born from contaminated water or sweating. So this exhaust, everything, all the bodies. and the all the bodies are nothing but bhoga yatanam. That means the seat for enjoyment. Subject enjoys the objects sitting in this body. So all this plus bhogya rupa annapanadikam, the objects being enjoyed, food and drink, etc. Plus etad ayatana bhuta. So where does these people stay who enjoy, and where is the food which is enjoyed? All this is within the bhuradi chaturdasha bhuvanani. Bhu is earth. Bhur bhuva swaha jana mahajana tapa satyam, seven worlds above, including earth seven, and then seven below, tala tala patala rasatala, etc. All these 14 lokas are the place where these beings stay and enjoy their food. Itadayana bhutam brahmandam. So all this totality is called the cosmos, brahmanda. Means together, all these together. The brahmanda, the 14 bhuvanas, the four types of bodies, and the food and drink of them. All this total gross world. Etesham karana rupam. What was the cause of that? The combined five elements. Rupam bhavati, matram bhavati. That means now we do not see man, woman, so and so, so and so. We see only the five elements. Five elements in the form of man. Five elements in the form of woman. Five elements in the form of heaven. Five elements in the form of earth. Five elements in the form of nara. Five elements as food and drink. So the vision changes completely. And in this way, the guru tells that this is not there. You can see that it is nothing but five gross elements. Etani, shabdadi vishaya sahitani, panchikrutani bhutani, sukshma sharira jatam cha, etat sarvam, etesham karana rupa, apanchikruta bhuta matram bhavati. We are told that there are five subtle elements. On one side, they make the sukshma world, sukshma body, sukshma world. On the other side, it becomes the five gross elements. So now the five, we have seen that the whole world is nothing but five gross elements. Shabdadi vishaya sahitani, along with the five qualities of those five elements. That means how we understand space, akasha, by the quality of sound. How we understand vayu by the quality of touch. How we understand teja by the quality of form. How we understand apa by the quality of taste. How we understand prithvi by the quality of smell. So all these five elements, along with the five characteristics of them, bhutani. Bhutani means five gross elements. Five gross elements along with their five characteristics. One side, sukshma sharira jatam. On the other side, the totality of sukshma shariras. Ya etat sarvam. All these two together. Karana rupa, what was their cause? Apanche kruta bhuta. The non-combined, the elemental five types of matter was the cause of one side, all sukshma shariras, the other side, the five gross elements. So five gross elements along with their characteristics and all the sukshma shariras are now seen. They are not seen now. What is seen now? The subtle elements. These five subtle elements, that is what is my mind. The five subtle elements, that is what is my indriyas. The five subtle elements, that is the objects. And we also see that the five subtle elements are these five gross elements combined. So that is called second step of apavada. Etani सत्वादि गुण सहितानि अपंचीकृतानि उत्पत्ति विक्रमेण एतत् कारणभूत अज्ञान उपहित चैतन्य मात्रं भवति व्युत्पत्ति विक्रमेण हाउ दे वर बॉर्न द अर्थ वाज बॉर्न फ्रॉम द एलिमेंटल अर्थ वाज ब्रॉम फ्रॉम एलिमेंटल अप एलिमेंटल वाटर वाज बॉर्न फ्रॉम एलिमेंटल तेज एलिमेंटल तेज वाज born from elemental vayu was born from elemental space and they were also exhibiting sattva rajatama characteristics because the matter was from tamoguna the pancha pranas were from rajoguna indriyas were from sattoguna so the five subtle elements along with sattva rajatama utpatti vidkramena the reverse order of their being born that means instead of earth subtle element called earth we will see now subtle element of water this is clearly what is called jnana pralaya and that may be actually happening in pralaya but we see in our consciousness that we do not see we saw five subtle elements now we see one of them is missing There is no subtle element called earth. What is that? Subtle element called water. Other four are there. Then we see the subtle element water also has vanished. It is only the subtle element of tej plus akash and vayu. Then we see the subtle element of tej has vanished. It is nothing but subtle element of vayu plus akash. Then we see the subtle element of vayu also has gone into the subtle element of akash. So in this order, then where does this akasha go? Ajnana, upahita, chaitanya matram. From where this akasha was born? From the Brahman, which was covered by ajnana, which was covered by the avarani and vikshepa shakti, the chetan. Chetan itself was the nimitta karan, the covering was the upadan karan. In that way, akasha was born. Etasmad atmana akasha sambuddha. So now even the space has vanished, and we only see that chaitanya, which is covered by this ajnana, this wrong knowledge, or the vikshepa and avarani shakti. Then. एतद् अज्ञानम् अज्ञान उपहितम् चैतन्यम् च ईश्वरादिकम् एतद् आधारभूत अनुपहित चैतन्य रूपम् तुरीयम् ब्रह्म मात्रम् भवति नाउ टू थिंग्स आर हियर द चैतन्य कवर्ड बाय सो कॉल्ड कवर्ड बाय एज इफ बाय द अज्ञान एंड द अज्ञान इटसेल्फ सो Ajnana itself, the avarani and vikshepa shakti, and also the chetan covered by the ajnana. These two. What was their base? The base was uncovered pure consciousness. That uncovered pure consciousness is called turiya, means fourth, because it is present in jagrat, sapna, sushupti. But it is not involved in any three of them. It is separate, but is present in all the three. So it is called fourth or turiya, the original chaitanya, which appeared to be covered by the covered chaitanya plus the covering. Covered chaitanya plus the covering was appearing in place of real pure chaitanya. Now they have vanished, and we see only the. Pure Chaitanya, that means Brahman, that is called Apavada. So, Apavada step by step has led us to the Turiyam Brahma Matram Bhavati. So, that is Apavada. So, to explain superimposition, he took such a long course. But to take Apada in a few steps, he has shown that. Now, important second topic. That is, the Guru teaches through Adhyaropana Apad that your real nature is Brahman. So what happens when we realize this Adhyaropana Apad? Abhyam Adhyaropa Apad Abhyam Tattvam Padartha Shodhanamapi Siddham Bhavati. There is a famous Vedic dictum, Tattvamasi, that thou art. But that means remote. Thou means limited. That is the impure literal meaning which comes in the mind. But when we undergo the process of Adhyaropana Apad, when we change our present consciousness through the Adhyaropana Apad, what happens? We get the pure notion about that. That the pure notion about that is that that is not remote. It is all pervading. So it is everything. It is one without a second. It includes me. That is how the term that becomes pure, purified. That means the term becomes purified is not a grammar, please. Term becomes purified means that in our consciousness about that changes. Our consciousness about Ishvara becomes consciousness of Brahman. Our consciousness of He, that is remote, changes into that which is very near. And when we are Tom corresponds to my feeling I. Now, whenever I used to think of I used to think of body, mind, indriyas, and consciousness. That was impure. That was the literal meaning. But now my consciousness has changed by Guru's teaching Adhyaropana Apad. So myself I see. And self has no body, mind. I told you that my thing, unless it goes away, I have not attained my reality. So that is called purification of the term thou. Not grammar, but my consciousness about myself undergoes such a change that I now realize I am the Chetan, nothing else. And automatically then, the Chetan called that is the same as Chetan called this. So, Adhyaropana purifies the two terms. Shodhanamapi Siddham Bhavati becomes established. This purification of the meaning of the terms becomes established. Tathai is example is explaining what is purified. Ajnanadi samashtihi etad upaitam sarvajnatvadi vishishtam chaitanyam etad anupaitam etad trayam taptaya pindavad ekatvena avasamanam tatpada vachyartho bhavati. What was the literal meaning of tatpada? The samashti bhut ajnan and Chetan covered by the samashti bhut ajnan. It has sarvajnatva adi vishishtam. It is all knowing, all powerful, etc., etc. And actually, it is the pure consciousness only. So, three things. Ajnana samashti, the Chetan covered by the ajnana samashti, and uncovered by the ajnana samashti. These three things were coming mixed in our mind when we are using the word that. When we are using the word that, we used to feel the sarvajna, etc., Ishwar. We used to feel the total. We have seen Ajnana Samashti means Devatma Shakti Swagunirni Guda. So that Avarani and Vikshepa Shakti of God and what we call God and the real nature, Brahman. All these three things mixed together. Example, iron ball heated in fire. So iron ball appears hot. So iron ball and the hot iron ball and the fire in the iron ball, these things become mixed in our mind. Like that, these three things mixed used to come in our consciousness. We had some inkling of Brahman, but it was mixed with these. That was the literal meaning of the word that. Now what has happened? Etad upadi upayita adharabhutam anupayitam chaitanyam tatpada lakshartho bhavati. So the covering and that which appeared covered and the uncovered reality, these three have become separated now. We see only the uncovered reality now. We are neither seeing the covering nor we see the covered reality, we see the uncovered reality alone. That is the indicated meaning of the word that. When the Guru said that, his indication was that reality which appeared covered and the covering which appeared, all this was mixed in our mind. But now, following this Adharupa Pada, we find that it is nothing but pure consciousness. That is called laksharatha, indicated meaning. Similarly, on our side, ajnanadi vyashti, the individual ajnana, we have seen these two things are different. Though Sadanandayati is using the common word, in one case the samashti ajnana is devatma shakti, on the other side, the ajnana is individual's wrong consciousness. So ajnanadi vyashti. Ajnanadi vyashti means the individualized wrong consciousness. Etad upayita, and the chetan covered by this was alpajnatvadi vishishta. I know very little. So my chetan was covered by this vyashti ajnan, which is always malina sattva pradhan, having rajogun, tamogun, etc. So my knowledge became very limited. Etad anupaitam chaita, anupaitam cha, but there was the pure consciousness. So pure consciousness, individual covered consciousness and individual covering. Class salu is at the class salu. So these three were getting mixed up when Guru told me you, thou. Guru told me thou. In my mind, these three things were getting mixed up. My reality, which is pure consciousness, the individualized, the covered consciousness, and which was alpajna, and the individualized covering. These three things mixed together was the literal meaning of the word thou. Example same, heated iron ball, taptaya pindavat ekatvena avasamanam. These three became mixed. Tam padartha vacharatho bhavati was the literal meaning of the word tam. Now, due to Adharupa Pada, etad upadi upaita adharabhutam anupaitam pratyaganandam turiyam chaitanyam tvampada laksharatho bhavati. So the upadi, upaita, what is the real adhar for them, was the uncovered pure consciousness, which was of the sort of innermost reality and which was of the sort of bliss. So, I now understand, I now realize that the Guru says, you, thou, it does not mean this body and mind and this mixture and alpajnatva, etc. It means only the pure innermost consciousness, which is nothing but bliss. So, that was the indicated meaning. In this way, the meaning has become purified. Meaning has become purified means In place of the literal meaning, due to Adhara Papad, now the real meaning shines in me. So both are only pure consciousness. So automatically there is identity. Now, this very process can be achieved in a different way. Tattvam Asi. Guru told me that you, thou art. So, what I should get by that? Akhanda, one reality, unbroken, homogeneous, undivided, one consciousness is the intended meaning, indicated meaning of the sentence Tattvamasi. If we follow Adharopana path very clearly, then the two terms become purified, automatically they are identical. But if we try to understand is not by intellect, realize the meaning of the sentence, we can arrive at the same consciousness. So that being described now. Very important something we are following now. Atha Mahavakya artho varnyate. Now, the meaning of the Mahavakya. Mahavakya means that sentence which in one sentence tells us that identity between Jiva and Brahman, that is called Mahavakya. And this Mahavakya here means Tattvamasi. The meaning of Tattvamasi, the real intended meaning of Tattvamasi is being described now. Idam Tattvamasi Vakyam Sambandhatrayana Akhandartha Bodhakam Bhavati. Here I have to tell you something original. Original means which does not appear in the book, though it is there in the book. Let me tell you here. This Vedanta Sar has two or three commentaries. And one of the commentaries is called Vidvan Manoranjani commentary. In that we are told, here it is being said, Sambandhatrayana, three types of relations between the word Tattvam, Tat and Tvam. We'll give the Akhandartha. We'll give the homogeneous, unbroken meaning. Vidvan Manoranjani tells that first you apply one of them for some time, then you go to the other for some time, then you go to the third for some time. Now, I am not saying it is wrong. It is one way. But what Sadananda is telling us, all three ways can directly lead to the akhanda meaning. He does not say one after the other. He says that the cluster of three relations, that means in three different relations, we'll see gradually, three different relations between the word Tat and Tvam will give us the unbroken meaning. Atha Mahavakyartho Varnate Idam Tattvamasi Vakyam Sambandhatrayana Akhandartha Bodhakam Bhavati. What are the three types of relations? Sambandha Trayam Nama Padayo Samanadikaranyam Padarthayor Visheshana Vishesha Bhava Pratyagatma Lakshanayor Laksha Lakshana Bhavascha Iti. First type of relation between the word Tat and Tvam is that Samanadikaranyam. Adikaran is location. We are using Tat and Tvam for the same location. That means when we are saying that, we are meaning Brahman, we are saying Thou, that also meaning Brahman. Same location here means the Akhanda Brahman. That is one type of relation. What it means in practical life? Something like Adhara Deva. We start by feeling that Brahman is my support. And when we go deep enough, we find the support and supported are one. So this feeling of support, Sri Ramakrishna said that the old rishis had shanta bhav, a peaceful relation between jiva and atman. And this peaceful relation is about the same location. In this body is described two birds. And the other bird understands finally that I am not there, it was a shadow. So in the same location, we can call it, the Vaishnavas describe five types of relations. Na? The first is Shantabhav. We can call it Shantabhav. We can call it Adharadeya Bhav. We can call it the Karmis or Yogis Adhar Bhav, and that culminates into Advaita. That is the first Sambandha. He will explain it still further, but by the name Samanadikarane, we understand this. Second is Padarthayor Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. Padartha means take the meaning of that. Take the meaning of thou. And they become adjectives of each other. They become adjectives of each other. In practical life, it means the remaining four bhavas of the Vaishnavas. God is my, I am God's servant, God is my master. I am God's friend, God is my friend. I am God's mother or father, God is my child. I have the sweet relation with God. I am the beloved of God. I am the lover. This very relation in Sufi's case is interchanged. They feel I am the lover, God is the beloved girl. These are the four bhavas of Vaishnavas. Plus, take any other bhavas. That is, God is my mother or father. I am God's child. Take in the Gita, God is my grandfather. I am his grandchild. So, and some philosophical relations also. God is my being. So, all these are different relations. They are what type of relation? Paraspar Vishesha Vishesha. That means God is mine. And who am I? I am God's. If both are there, I do not belong to the world. I belong to God. And God is mine. God is not some strange being. We the common people have God is some strange being. But the devotee's God is mine. So, I am defined by God, God is defined by me. This when pursued leads to the difference between the two vanishing. What remains? Only one pure consciousness. The third is Pratyagatma Lakshana Yor Laksha Lakshana Bhava. That was what we are seeing up till now. That the innermost reality was the indicated meaning of thou. And the pure consciousness alone was the indicated meaning of that. So between them the relation is take the indicated meanings. So Adhara Papad has explained us through the indicated meanings, the identity. But this very thing in practical life can be realized through the Shanta Bhav or all the relational bhavas with God, provided they both each other qualify each other. Generally what happens? God is my mother. I am not changed. Really, God is my mother. I am God's child. So I am no more so and so child. I am no more so and so's father. I am God's child. So the explanation for me becomes God's, and God is mine. This directly can lead to the identity consciousness. One way is that this you apply, become very near to God, and then apply the indicated meaning. We agree with Vidwan Manoranjini, but directly also it can be realized. And I am not telling something subjectively. Shankaracharya, in his commentary on the Chandogya Upanishad, has very clearly defined this. I have not brought the Chandogya today. Next week I may bring, but here, those who want reference, if they bring Chandogya in the next class, Shankara's commentary on 4th Adhyaya of Chandogya, 10th section. 10th section of the 4th chapter of Chandogya explains in detail this Vishesha Visheshan between Atman and Brahman. And again, very clearly he tells it in 5th chapter, 11th section, 1st mantra. Please note down, refer to it, or next time you bring that, I will read that. So, I am not telling subjectively, basing upon Shankaracharya's commentary. He has very clearly shown how this Vishesha Visheshana Sambandha can lead to a realization of identity. Again, remember, Chandogya, 4th Adhyaya, 10th section, full section, and 5th Adhyaya, 11th section, 1st mantra. And the other source is Sri Ramakrishna Leela Prasanga, the scripture of scripture, the greatest scripture. There, Saradanandaji has in detailed explained how this Sagun Sakar Upasana, how this worshipping the qualified Brahman in a relation with that, how it gradually purifies the mind, how gradually we feel unity with that. And there itself he has indicated the two paths. Example, Sri Ramakrishna had made a habit. He had Nirvikal Samadhi before, but he had made a habit of feeling God as the universal mother. And when that universal mother came before him, he took Jnana as the khadga and cut it. That means from the Vishesha Visheshana Sambandha he went to Laksha Lakshmana Sambandha. All right. But Saradhan Swamiji says this intense love itself can remove the difference and the identity is established. So, one source of what I am telling now is Shankara's commentary in the Chandogya Upanishad. The other source where I am telling you now that the Vishesha Visheshana Sambandha can lead to Laksha Lakshana Sambandha, bhakti changing into jnana, or bhakti itself leading to Nirvikal Samadhi. On the basis of Sri Ramakrishna Leela Prasanga, where Saradhan Swamiji says, I will quote the section and chapter next time, where Saradhan Swamiji says, I will now explain how this iti iti sadhana can lead to Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So, these two are the sources where this, on one side, we agree with Vidwan Manoranjini that they can be applied step by step. On the other side, any one of them can lead to Advaita. Sri Ramakrishna has established in his own life. Up to Sri Ramakrishna's advent, even today, those who do not understand this, the jnanis will say bhakti is already in Dvaita. And bhaktas will also say we are in Dvaita. At the most, they will say Achintya Bhedabhed. But that is not full bhakti. That is real bhakti, culminates in Advaita, has been clearly established by Sri Ramakrishna in his own life and teachings. So here, the Sadandaiti is telling us that by three relations, you can, the main question is akhanda consciousness. Main question is that we should feel not the divided consciousness, but the akhanda consciousness. So, sambandha trayam nama, padayo samanadi karanyam, padarthayo visheshana vishesha bhava, pratyagatma lakshanayor, laksha lakshana bhavaschaiti. Taduktam, he quotes, samanadi karanyam cha visheshana visheshata, laksha lakshana sambandha padartha pratyagatma nam. This is from Naishkarma Siddhi of Sureshwaracharya. Here also, he does not mention that one should be changed to the other. Now he starts explaining. Samanadhikaranya sambandha. The example taken to explain the word that is Soyam Devadatta. I had a friend called Devadatta. I had seen him some years before. After some years, I see him again. I recognize this is that Devadatta. So this is that Devadatta means in the same person, I am saying this and that. That referring to past tense. This referring to present tense. But they are being used in the case of the same Devadatta. That is called the Samanadhikaranya. Similarly, that referred to remote. This refers to Alpajnam. But they are being referred to the same location called the pure consciousness. Samanadhikaranya sambandha stavat. So, Samanadhikaranya sambandha is like this. Yatha soyam devadatta iti asmin vakke. Like in the sentence, he is that Devadatta. Tatkala Vishishta Devadatta Vachaka Sa Shabdasya. Sa Shabda is telling us about Devadatta of the past. Etat Kala Vishishta Devadatta Vachaka Ayam Shabdasya. And this Devadatta, this means Devadatta as associated with the present time. Ekasmin pinde tatpare sambandha. Tatpare means the ultimate meaning of that is in the same body. Pinde. In the same body, I am telling that and this Devadatta. Example. Tathacha. Tattvamasiti vakyepi parokshatvadi visheshta chaitanya vachaka tat padasya. Padasya, it has become padasya. So that meant remote consciousness. And aparokshatvadi vishnu chaitanya vachakatvam padasya. Dau means here directly, aparoksha. I myself am, no I am. So ekasmin chaitanya tatpare sambandha, but both are referring to the same consciousness. Both are referring to the same pure consciousness. We understood distant, remote, we understood this, but we have seen now that both remain the same consciousness. So about the same consciousness, we are telling that and thou. So this is called the samanadhikaranya sambandha. The relation between tat and tvam is in the same location we are using the word tat and tvam. Like soyam devadatta, we are using sa and ayam in the same location called the body of devadatta. This is samanyadhikarana sambandha. So it is leading to akhandartha. विशेषण विशेष भाव संबंधस्तु टू मीन्स बट ए डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रिलेशन वंडरफुल ब्रॉडनेस सदांत इट इज शोइंग बिकॉज दैट इज रियल लाइफ वेदांता इज नॉट ए स्टडी इंटेलेक्चुअल वेदांता इज रियलाइजेशन सो वेन यू प्रोसीड थ्रू डिफरेंट मोड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वी रीच द सेम गोल दिस इज वॉट श्री रामकृष्ण केम टू एस्टैब्लिश यथा तत्रैव वाक्ये सेम सेंटेंस स्वयं देवदत्त स शब्दार्थ तत्काल विशिष्ट देवदत्तस्य सो दैट देवदत्त बिकम्स द विशेषण ऑफ दिस देवदत्त दैट देवदत्त दिस देवदत्त इज दैट देवदत्त सो दैट इज दैट बिकम द एडजेक्टिव ऑफ दिस देवदत्त अयम शब्दार्थ एतत्काल विशिष्ट देवदत्तस्य च अन्योन्य भेद व्यावर्तकतया विशेषण विशेष भाव द मेन वर्ड क्रक्स इज अन्योन्य भेद व्यावर्तन आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट अ लिटिल सदानंद विल टेल लेटर ऑन व्हेन वी से ब्लू लोटस ब्लू इज डिफरेंट लोटस इज डिफरेंट वॉट डज ब्लू टेल मी नॉट रेड नॉट ब्लैक ब्लू What does lotus tell me? No rose or any other flower or not other thing but a lotus flower. So the blue removes the other colors. Lotus removes the other objects, but they are not removing their mutual difference. Because lotus can be of many colors. Blue can be applied to many things. That now, here what is happening? That God is mine, I am God's. This removes the mutual difference. Anyona bhede vavartan. That is the most important word in vishesha visheshana sambandha. We'll take it up again next time. But today I'm telling you, vishesha visheshana sambandha. Anyona bhede vavartakate removing the bheda between the two. Vishesha visheshana bhava. This is what is the qualified and qualified relation on both sides. That is the example of tat svayam devadatta. Tatha atrapi vakke tat padartha parokshatvadi vishishta chaitanyasya tvam padartha aparokshatvadi vishishta chaitanyasya cha anyonya bheda vyavartakaya visheshana vishesha bhava. This visheshana vishesha bhava is removing the mutual difference. And so the identity remains. This we shall see on the next term with the help of Shankaracharya Chandogya Bhashya and also the Leela Prasanga portion. Laksha Lakshana Sambandha, let me read. Laksha Lakshana Sambandhastu Yatha Tatreva Sa Shabda Ayam Shabdayor Tad Artha Yorva विरुद्ध तत्काल एतत्काल विशिष्टत्व परित्यागेन अविरुद्ध देवदत्तेन स लक्ष्य लक्षण भाव वी आर टेकिंग द सेम सेंटेंस स्वयं देवदत्त सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस दैट काल एंड दिस काल आर द थिंग्स कॉन्ट्रडिक्टिंग विच अदर सो वी रिमूव दैट कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन एंड मीन ओनली देवदत्त वी आर टेकिंग Half the meaning of so Devadatta. That we are removing and taking Devadatta. And we are taking half of this Devadatta. This we are removing, taking Devadatta. So this is the called Bhaga Lakshana or Laksha Lakshana Sambandha, indicatory words and indicated thing. Viruddha Devadattena sa Laksha Lakshana Bhava. तथा अत्र अपि वाक्ये तत्त्वं पदयो तदर्थयोर्व आदर द टू वर्ड्स देमसेल्व्स आर देयर मीनिंग विरुद्ध परोक्षत्व अपरोक्षत्व आदि विशिष्टत्व परित्यागेन दोस थिंग्स विच आर कॉन्ट्रडिक्टिंग द रिमोट एंड द नियर रिमूव देम चैतन्येन स लक्ष्य लक्षण भाव दे आर मीनिंग द सेम कॉन्शियसनेस सो नाउ What are the defects in each of them will be explained. what are the right in this method will be explained. That does not mean that any of the sambandhas are wrong. But while applying laksha lakshana sambandha, what mistakes can happen while applying vishesha visheshana or samanandikarana sambandha, what mistakes can happen, that Sadananda Iti will describe. Before taking them up, we shall see in the next turn the Chandogya Upanishad and Leela Prasanga, great master, and try to explain specially about the vishesha visheshana bhava, because this leads to fara. Because people refer to Vidvan Manoranjini. Vidvan Manoranjini we do not deny, but the other way also is possible. That is what Sadananda Yati himself is telling Samandatrayana. Why should we reject that meaning? And it is explained by Shankaracharya himself in Chandogya and by Sardhan Swamiji in the Great Master, that we shall try to see on the next term. Om Akhandam Satchidanandam Avang Manasa Gocharam Atmanam Akhila Dharam Ashraye Bhishta Siddhaye Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamas.